Hi guys, welcome to Prsoft technical channel. In the C language series, today we are going to see the program number 26. In the last lecture, I explained you about how to print given number in a reverse order. So now in this lecture, I'm going to explain you about Fibonacci series. This is very very important program in your labs, because many people will get this program. Also, if you are going to write your final exam, you will get this question for 10 marks. So let's start with this program, guys. What is the meaning of Fibonacci series? Suppose example, first you have to read two numbers from the user. I will take two number as 01. Guys, it is not fixed. You can take any number. Then next number will print the addition of these two number. What is the addition of these two number? 1. So now next number will print addition of last two number. Last two number is 1, 1. So addition of 1, 1 is 2. The next number will be what? Addition of last two number, nothing but 3. So next number will be 5, and so on it will go. So how to design the logic? First we will see, guys. So first you have to read these two numbers, starting numbers from the user, and then you have to add this number and print, and again you have to last two number you have to add and you have to print. So this is the Fibonacci series. So how to develop the logic and how to do this programming, just we will see with one program. So I have started with dev C++. I will take a new file, go to file, take a source file, add two header files, conio.h. now white main, and then read the two values. Integer I will take n1, n2, I will take one temporary variable t also. Why we need t, guys, I will tell you in couple of minutes. Enter two numbers. So I will take a two numbers from here from the user. You can give the meaningful message, enter the first number, enter the second number, how you want. You can just read it, guys. It is up to you. Already we discussed lot of program regarding this, how to read the values and all. So you can just check it, those programs. Now we read the two numbers. So guys, initially we have to print those numbers. So I will print that number, percentile d space percentile d, means whatever the numbers are there, those number will be print on the screen. So up to first we will just execute this program. So on the screen it will come the both the programs. So just I will compile once. It is asking me to save, so I will give fib.c, nothing but fibonacci.c, and I will run. It is asking me first number, I will give first and 6. So two numbers are printed. Now we have to continue this series. Now here one more thing, but this series, how many till, like suppose I have printed 2, how many numbers you want to print more, like 5, 6, 7, 8? For that is also you have to read from the user, because if you want to fix it like 5 times 10 times, that is also possible. Enter how many times you want to repeat Fibonacci. Okay, you can give any message is related. Just I am giving one example message here, and you will read that number into one variable. I will take one variable called comma up to x. X number will be there, just we are taking x. So this will be print up to x. So this I will read, not here, before printing I have to read this. Scanf, because once we have print mint, it should come in a single line. So then I have to repeat how many times. See, already we have print the two values. So x, suppose example user has given 7, so already two values is printed. So how many times it should print? 5 times. So I will write here one code. I will take one more value, called it I is equals to initial value is 1. So here I less than or equals to, I will do x minus 2, because already two values printed. So suppose example x value is 7, so it will execute only 5 times, because two value already printed. Now next, what we have to do, we have to add the two number and we have to print. So I will take one that temporary variable, I will add what, n1 plus n2. Guys, if you are not understanding, don't worry, I will explain you this code with diagrammatic. Just wait for a minute and I will print that third value. Okay, here I am giving space, because here I did not add the space. So here I am giving space, and here I will add the comma, and what is the value we want to print? T value. Now see here, guys, Now again, what we have to do, last value, last two value, it should come next time. So I will just change it. I will do here n1 is equals to n2 and n2 is equals to t. Why I am doing this all, I will tell you. Now see here, with diagrammatic I will explain you this. Now see, how many variables we are having totally, guys? We are having n1, we are having n2, we are having t, we are having x, and we are having I. Now n1 value is, suppose example, you imagine that we are giving 2 and 3. I am taking starting value is 2 and 3. Any value you can give, there is no restriction 0 and 1. And temporary variable we have to count. X I will consider 5, because up to 5 I want to print. Then next is what, I is initially 1. Now just check it here. Suppose example, I am having here starting, I am printing 2 and 3. So 2 and 3 will be print on the screen here. This is the screen, will you imagine, guys? 2 and 3 is printed on the screen. Now I less than or equals to x minus I. X value is 5. Minus I is nothing but 3. I is 1 less than or equals to 3. Condition true. It will come inside. T is equals to n1 plus n2. N1 n plus n2 is nothing but 5. And it will assign to what? T. And now T is printed on the screen. So T is printed. Now see, last two number addition is what? 5. So we got 5. Now n2 will assign to n1. So n2 value is what? 3. It will assign to n1. Now t value is assigned to n2. So t value is assigned to n2. Because what? We have to do the addition of two number in the next time. So now once again this while loop repeat, because it was not false. So I plus plus. Here we have to write, guys, I plus plus. Okay, because after this I plus plus, I value will increment to what? 2. Now 2 less than or equals to 3. 3 y x minus 2, guys, remember. 2 less than or equals to 3. Condition true. It will come inside. T is equals to n1 plus n2. What is the n1 value now? 3. N2 value? 5. 3 plus 5? 8. We are going to print 8. Now see here, guys. Last two number addition is 8. We are getting? Okay. Similar next thing. N2 will assign to n1. Nothing but 5 will assign to this one. Now T will assign to n2. So like this. Again, I plus plus, it will increment to 3. Now again, 3 less than or equals to 3. Condition true. It will come inside. T is equals to n1 plus n2. Nothing but what? 13. And 13 will be printed here. This value will change first time 8. And then now it is 13. Okay. I did not change. Here 13. So now T value will printed here. T value will become what? 13. So now next. Again, n1 plus n2. It will assign. Here it will assign 8. Here it will assign 13. But I plus plus will be 4. 4 less than or equals to 3, condition false. So it will come out. Total how many output we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this, like this, we have to do it. So just we will compile and we will try this program. Compile. Okay. Now run the program. I am giving what? First number is 2. Second number is 3. And up to how many numbers we want? 5. Okay. Something wrong. Just I have to check here, guys. What is wrong here? Okay, here I did not read the address, guys. So sorry for that. So just once again I will compile and I will run the program once again. I will give here 5. Sorry, first value is 2, second value is 3, and up to how many variables we want? 5. So like this we got it. Say similar output we got here. So like this we have to execute the Fibonacci series, guys. If you change the numbers also, there will be the no problem. So just we'll try with, we'll change the number. I will give here, starting number is 4, next number is 5, and up to how many? 9 numbers I want. See, 4, 5, 9, this addition is 14, this is 23, 37, like this it will goes on. So like this, guys, we have to execute about what? Fibonacci series, guys. Guys, if you like my video, please subscribe my channel for more videos, guys. Thank you for watching this video, guys.